Claudia Lawrence was a 35-year-old chef who disappeared from York, England on March 18, 2009. Lawrence was last seen walking home from work, and her body has never been found. Her case remains unsolved, and it is one of the most high-profile missing persons cases in the United Kingdom. Here is her story. Claudia Elizabeth Lawrence was born in Malton, North Yorkshire in 1974. She was a talented chef, and she worked at a popular restaurant in York called the University Arms. She was also a keen runner, and she was often seen running in the park near her home. Lawrence was a well-liked and respected member of the community. She was described as being bubbly and outgoing, and she had a wide circle of friends. She was also a loving daughter and sister, and her disappearance has had a devastating impact on her family and friends. On March 18, 2009, Lawrence left work at around 2:30 p.m. She was seen on CCTV footage walking home, and she was never seen or heard from again. The police have investigated Lawrence's disappearance extensively, but they have not been able to find any clues to her whereabouts. Here is what we know so far. On the morning of March 18, 2009, Claudia Lawrence left her home at 46 Heworth Road in York, England, to go to work at the University of York's Goodrich College's Roger Kirk Center at 6 a.m. like every morning. She finished her shift at 2 p.m., and then she was seen leaving the building at 2:31 p.m. At 2:47 p.m., she is seen in CCTV footage walking on Melrose Gate in York. She seemed to drop something at a local mailbox. Later that day, Claudia spoke to her parents on the phone at 8:23 p.m. She seemed very relaxed and sounded like herself. This was the last time anyone heard from her. The next day, Claudia did not show up to work. Later that day, she was supposed to meet her friend Susie at the pub. Susie waited for an hour, but Claudia never showed up. Susie then called Claudia's father, Peter, to let him know that Claudia was missing. Peter tried to contact Claudia, but her phone went straight to voicemail. He then called Claudia's place of work, but they told him that she had not called in sick and that she did not go to work that day. Peter then went to Claudia's house, but she was not there. He checked the house and her bed was made. There was no sign of a disturbance, and her other belongings were untouched. However, he noticed that her backpack and phone were missing. This suggested that Claudia had left her home voluntarily, but that something may have happened to her after she left. Peter didn't know what had happened to Claudia, but he knew that it wasn't good. He called the police and reported her missing. The police arrived at Claudia's house and started a search in the immediate area. They searched her home, the surrounding streets, and the nearby park. However, they were unable to find any sign of Claudia. A press conference was held, and Claudia's case was featured in the newspaper. The headline read, "Please come home." The article described Claudia's disappearance and the police investigation. It also included a plea from Claudia's family for anyone with information about her whereabouts to come forward. The case remained unsolved for 5 weeks. On April 10, 2009, the police reclassified Claudia's case as a suspected murder case. They believed that Claudia had been abducted and murdered, and they launched a renewed investigation. The police searched over 271 houses in the area, but they were unable to find any sign of Claudia. They also interviewed over 1,000 people, but they were unable to find any leads. However, there were a few witnesses who came forward with information that may have been relevant to the case. One witness reported seeing a man and a woman arguing near Claudia's house on the night she disappeared. The witness said that the man was about 6 feet tall and had short brown hair. He was wearing a blue jacket and jeans. The woman was about 5 feet 5 inches tall and had long blonde hair. She was wearing a black jacket and jeans. The witness said that the man and woman were arguing loudly, and they seemed to be very upset. The witness said that the man was yelling at the woman, and the woman was crying. The witness said that the argument lasted for about 10 minutes, and then the man and woman walked away in different directions. The police followed up on this lead, but they were unable to identify the man or the woman. The witness was unable to provide any further information about them, and the police were unable to find any other witnesses who saw the man and woman arguing. The next morning after Claudia disappeared, she was supposed to go to work. She always took the same route, and the police eventually verified and released footage from the camera that captured her before at Melrose Gate. The footage showed different individuals walking down the street, but none of them resembled Claudia's features or body. The police believe that Claudia may have been abducted on the night before, and that she was not seen on the morning of her disappearance. The police later concluded that Claudia disappeared on the morning of March 19th, the day that she was supposed to go to work at 6 a.m. They started a forensic investigation at Claudia's home, but they found no clues. There were no signs of a struggle, and nothing was out of place. Claudia Lawrence's mobile phone was geolocated to her home in Heworth, York, on the morning of March 19th, 2009. The phone was turned off at 12:10 a.m., and it has never been found. The police have thoroughly reviewed Claudia's phone log, and there was no indication that she was doing anything but going to work the next day. There was no suspicious activity or anything at all. Later, there was an investigation into a white van that was parked outside Claudia's house the night before she disappeared. The van was seen by a neighbor, and the driver was described as a white male in his 40s. The police made a public appeal for the driver to come forward, but he has never been identified. In 2013, the police made another forensic investigation with new technology, finding different fingerprints on a cigarette. The cigarette was found on Claudia's car, which she did not use because it was broken down. However, no one has been found matching these prints. 127 suspects have been interrogated, and some have been arrested, but no one has been able to be linked to Claudia's case. In 2016, 7 years after Claudia's disappearance, police released CCTV footage of a man walking past her house on the night of March 18th. The man is seen walking past the house at 7:15 p.m., and then a minute later, he is seen walking back past the house with a bag in his back. A similar-looking man was seen the next morning going through the same alley. The police have released a notice to try to identify this man. They believe that he may have information that could help them solve Claudia's case. The police investigation into Claudia Lawrence's disappearance has been ongoing for over 14 years. They have searched a number of locations in York, including the University of York campus and the Heslington area. They have also made a number of arrests, but no one has been charged with Lawrence's murder. In 2016, Datsupt Dymalin completed a review of the case for North Yorkshire Police. He concluded that the person or persons responsible for Claudia's disappearance was someone or several people who were close to her. He also said that it was either very well planned, or that there was a huge element of luck involved in the perpetrator getting away with it. Malin also said that he believed that those closely associated with Claudia had withheld key information. He said that his team had spent 2 years unearthing new leads and theories, the most significant of which was considering the possibility that whatever happened to Claudia did so on March 18, 2009, and not the next day. This theory is supported by Clive Driscoll, who thinks it far more likely that Claudia came to harm overnight. He said that it could have all gone horribly sour the moment Claudia finished her phone call with her mother. He believes that the focus of the investigation should be on the time period after that phone call. Finally, in March 2022, North Yorkshire Police searched the River Ouse near York for any sign of her body. This was following a tip-off from a member of the public who believed they had seen Claudia's body in the river in 2009. However, no trace of Claudia was found during the search. Claudia Lawrence's disappearance is a tragedy that has left her family and friends heartbroken. After years of searching, there are still no answers as to what happened to her. The police are still investigating, and they are asking anyone with information to come forward. We hope that one day, Claudia will be found, and her family will finally find peace. If you like my content, please don't forget to leave a comment and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.